In this tutorial, I'll show you how to import an external image and use it as a background image in Blender. Type S and X to scale on the X axis. Let's import an external image as a plane. I'll share the link in the description below. S to scale. R, Z, and 90 to rotate the mesh 90 degrees on the Z axis. Let's set up the render scene. I'll scale the image to fit into the camera's point of view. I'll manually create a wooden material for the cube. Please avoid increasing the detail value to the max. My computer slowed down greatly when I did that. I'm thinking the detail value depends on how fast the computers are, but mine slowed down when it was set to 16. I'll lower the detail value close to 0. Let's press Shift, A, to create a teapot. If you don't see that in the menu, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. Control, 3, to subdivide. Right-click and shade smooth to smooth the surface. The first rule to remember is checking to see if the background image is reflecting any lights in the scene. If I increase this point light's value, the background will show the reflection, because the default material has some specular values. We'll lose the realism of the background image that way, and we must decrease the specular value to 0. The second thing to remember is to match the background's color to the meshes. Let me lower the light strength to show you what I mean. The background image is full of red and orange colors, but the meshes don't have them. This is why we need to add some compositing values to the scene. Let's add the usual split viewer and the mix node setup. The overlaying color will give far more realism to the scene by blending in two separate scene files from different light sources. The same rule is applied when we're mixing photos in Photoshop or any other image editing software out there. The idea is to add a color in between, in order to give an illusion of all objects being in the same place at the time of render. Before and after. The last thing we could do to add more realism is to add the depth of field. A tiny bit of blur will give far better realism result for the final render scene. Please test this composition method on background images that look completely out of place. Once we master this method, then we can easily mix pre-rendered scenes or external photos to give more realism to render images. Before and after. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.